human effort. Two things which are exclusive areas of industry compared to other engineering areas, like electrical engineering, civil engineering, metallurgical engineering. You say what is specialty of metallurgical engineering? You find the metals. Take the mining, take the mining metal, whatever the mining process is there, and create the new form of metal. So that is the metallurgy. Focus on metallurgy is that. Right? Like that, if you take mechanical engineering, what is the focus of mechanical engineering? Creating machines. Simple explanation is creating machines. But to run the machines, you require energy. Okay, creation of some form of energy is also there is a mechanism like steam. Lot of icing. Icing is for studying the mechanism. So you create energy and then you create the machine, which is converting the energy into useful work. Right? In the case of coal, you also can create the boiler, you use the steam, you make a steam engine, and then you convert into useful output. But the more focus is not on the steam. First focus is on the machine. Right? This unfortunately we are missing. We employ so many people every day for our process. We take over 450 people, all our engineers, and we are going to improve our output. Right? Nobody even says what is mechanical engineering. What is the new machines?
Point is that what is industry? Industry is
examine the efficiency of the systems. We examine the role of people in the systems. Industrial engineering is system efficiency engineering and human engineering. If you are creating a manufacturing system, examining the efficiency of the manufacturing system is the role of nature. Examining the role of people in the system, how people are going to run the machines. What is the study that a man is operating the system to a customer service? What is that study that is also important to study? SP is important to study. He is the efficiency and the people. These two things are SP and the world in the study in the engineering system. So the first thing is the product itself, you are going to study the product itself for its efficiency aspect. Second thing is the method, the process. Whatever process you have designed, machine processes, casting, polycasting, then it is conditioning, then you assembly. So whatever process you have designed, that efficiency of the process, that's what methods efficiency. Then industrial optimization. Now when you say optimization, you know operating research. When you are talking about that particular thing, you are talking about the operations research. Now operations research, there is no applications in number of disciplines. So we are trying to say specifically in the industry engineering activity, what is industry activity? Efficiency study. In the efficiency study, what is the application of the application? The industry engineering. Similarly, application of statistics. Once the stats are applied in various disciplines, it is applied in economics. It is called as economics. It is applied in biology. It is called as biometrics. Right? In various subjects, it is applied in various names. And in industry engineering also, if you apply, we are saying industry engineering studies. Similarly, industry economics. Industry economics is economic evaluation of a technical solution. The solution is first to be taken. Right? In the airplane, shall I use a titanium or shall I use aluminum? Or shall I use a steel material? Conventionally, let us say something is being used. Alternatively, aluminum has come. Alternatively, titanium has come. Which should be used? Right? The technical something, they cannot fail. Most should come down. So technically, there is something. But from those technical alternatives, which is the economic? That is the question which you have to examine. You have to examine as an engineer. Every engineer is supposed to examine the economic consequences of the technical decisions. Every engineer has to. Engineering economics has to be taught to every engineer. There are actually subjects. Civil engineering economics, electrical engineering economics, mechanical economics, chemical engineering economics. Like that, in each and every subject, there are SPUs of the different right? Now, same thing you are saying, there is something new as the industrial economics. If you have to look at whatever this industry says, you also subject it to the same economic language. As an industrial engineer, I give a solution, it must be subjected to economic language. And so it counts for alternatives. Every industrial engineer has three alternatives to suggest. Which alternative I am going to suggest? That depends upon the economic application. Then the so-called human effort is how much time should you have? How much weight should you have? All these things are important. And then you should not be free. You should not be sick because you are feeling it. You should not affect yourself. You should retire from your company. You should not keep that kind of way of working. You can see, 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 then something called management. I want to come and lecture people to get it here. There is some management here. Economic governance, engineering governance. It does happen sometimes. It may happen in the life that sometimes students have such a problem. should not happen. Local management. Basically, what is management? Basically, management is a customer and a service provider relationship. If you are a service provider and there is a customer, the customer must be happy. Only when somebody is happy, you want to maintain the relationship with you. That will help out as well. Why diverse happens? Why the life happens? Diverse happens when there is unhappiness, unbalanced relationship. The life continues to exist, it is a gravity relationship. Management is always how to maintain this gravity relationship. Any relationship you have to learn management, you have to maintain a relationship with two people. What I'm going to do tomorrow, I'm going to do tomorrow, I'm going to do tomorrow, he said this is what we're going to do, and I'm going to do it. And this one, so then it gives you ideas. It could be a study or be or you have a IT project, or your entire department, your manager of a department, your manager department, or yes, and yes, and so these are the main supportive areas in the industry engineering. What we say is industry engineering. What I will do is, I will quickly go to the end and come back to that what I want to do as an end. So this is what I have created this particular thing, a production industry today. A subject of course electrical industry in the industrial process. This is all the title. And the assumption is that in detail it was structured industry in the so your MTEC industry in the you may already have been discussing this. So we already, I am assuming that you already have the basic industrial engineering. So whatever we said, the industrial methods, they are already basics are already covered. So you know what in the economics, you know what in the economics, you know what is product design and something. So here, I am probably concentrating on exclusively on issues related to the manufacturing. The gypsum fixer design is an important issue where we need to do much more inputs to industry design specializing in the production industry. That is all concentrated on the industry engineering of production systems, industry engineering of production process. We can do industry engineering of civil engineering process, industry engineering of construction process. We can do industry engineering of power generation. We can go to government contract. And we can do industry engineering of thermal power generation. We can do industry engineering of thermal power distribution. But here we are concentrating on the industry engineering of mechanical production technique. This is what is our focus. Right? Second, there is something called SMED, single unit assembly test. Third, Kokayoke. Kokayoke is putting industry discussing in this particular process itself. Right? Within the machine, ability to put certain cams, etc. or something, so that if the product is defective, the product will not be able to go for it. Some operation you have not done, which is supposed to be done, you should not be able to go to the next operation. One of the examples I have seen recently, so what is very known? What happens in a particular word? If you put a spelling mistake, you are getting underline or red. Simple stuff of that. Okay. Yeah. I've seen something like I said in email that I am attaching something. Yeah. And then without attaching I said send, then I got the warning. You are supposed to send. I sent the email, I'm attaching the drone data, I sent the email. By the time you are going to send the email, I signed your statement or something, thanking you something, but sent. So the compiler will say, sorry. Here the emails are sent on the day, same email. So every time you miss a step, the emails are stopped. Now, such compiler should be in our mechanical checking. Then, automation of the machine is a very important thing. Automation is going on right from 1950 or 1960. The scene that we are studying today, we have to have a lot of way back to 1950. So, this is an important sort of thing because this is going to increase efficiency or lower the cost of the equipment. Then there is something called high speed machine. I just had that time scribbled out. Just out of several computing center. But now I found that is a important issue which is there. Then engineering economic analysis in robots. We are going to recommend robots. Sim is what? Basically CNC machines. You prepare robot, right? You prepare AGV. This is the combination. The sim is a combination of these things. So actually each and every thing you need to look at its engineering economic analysis. I just told you from robots. But you look at engineering economic analysis of CNC machines, you have the economic analysis of handy, which is robots, you look at lacking between the machines, you look at the AGVs, and they are trying to say even the warehouses are complicated, ASRs. You sit on the counter and say these materials should come, ASRs will be removed, give the material, AGV will bring it, robot will take it. To get to the machine, patient will machine, right? You have to try to do that. Now all that is subjected to engineering economic analysis. Easy profitable to do. It's going to be profitable for the company to implement all those things. Right? Then comes important. As you are doing automating and automating, the human power is replaced by electric power. So naturally you have to reduce the power consumption. Right? Then comes what is called as a workstation. Design. This is anywhere there, in the earlier thing. But you are once again now telling me, there is a part of this that how are you designing your machine? The CNC machine, what is happening? So what is happening? Station working on the CNC machine. Design for manufacturing is another sort of an important thing. So you as a manufacturing man should be able to assess the design and tell the designer whether the design is good for manufacturing. It's a design manufacturing interface. The designer should know something of manufacturing and has to optimize the design so that manufacturing is less. As a manufacturing man, you should be able to assess the design and tell him that why don't you give me a piece of changes, this is the result in the condition. The same thing comes as a design for assembly. Right? We combine that. Design for manufacturing and assembly. Then, AGVs and all our current speed. If you go to conventional type, how to minimize handling, you need to go for a gravity tool. Right? You sit and manufacture something, you don't bend, you leave it from the state, it should go down. That is not a damage. You need to design something that you leave it from the higher level, it goes down to gravity, that it goes without breaking, it goes to this way. You see an airport, some of the airport, the same thing. The airport, moving it, coming down, taking down, coming down, coming down. And sometimes you need to think something. Organs are not broken, hands are not broken. My own supply are not broken, people can be done in the body. That is every time I travel on the way, new suitcase will go. Because on the day it breaks, what are you going to do? You can go and handle that particular thing. So you need to talk about the gravity tube design as a special activity in the case of the workstation design and manufacturing. Right? Then, there is something I am saying is that a competency mapping for production creates and jobs. This is what Narayana Modi is telling. You have to create skilled people. Right? Make in India, make skilled India. So what are the skills required? Who is going to do the skills required? when you do that, you have to go to the person. So you should be able to talk about what are the skills you need to learn. Then only you can come to the people of the then only you can create idea and have a distinction to go. Then only you can do your own company in your own private school, you will be able to do those skills to learn. But you do not even know how to do it and create that particular thing. What is the competency required? To handle a particular machine which you are going to have a process. You can certainly have a problem. 3D implementation. Which we don't even know what happened. There are kind of new. So you have to decide 3D PD computer, what education should you give, what skills should you give, what laboratory training should you give. They're not good. Some filter. There are, when I am a child, I used to use those words. Sheep, pepper, 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 pepper. You have to decide, create that particular issue. Then, manufacturing cost analysis said reduction. So you have to take accounts. When the accounts people, they are creating an account statement. This is the cost of the manufacturing of this product. So you should be able to take that statement, analyze, understand what is there. Now, as an analyst, as an analyst, you are got the authority to tell the accountant, you are not giving me the information in the way I want. So you can tell in what way you want the information. Right? Then you should first of all know what you want to analyze, how you are going to analyze. Only when you know how you are going to analyze, then you are going to tell me, you are not giving information to me so that I can analyze properly. So you please give information in a different manner, the way I will talk. It is up to us, not to up to the accountant. Accountant doesn't know how you are going to analyze. Accountant does not know how you are going to analyze it. You are the manufacturing man. You are going to analyze and you are going to be faster. Accountant only will do some collection as of your company. So this is our subject. What is important for you? This subject is not accountant subject. This subject is our subject. Subject of industry. Subject of manufacturing managers, subject of manufacturing managers. Here on level and your manufacturing basis of rationalization. Same thing. Right? Accounting is more financial and information is non-financial. Totally different. Right? So same. Because you are not doing anymore personally, computer is collecting, you have to clean, say what computer should collect. So once again, you have to put your brain, you have to say what you want. First thing, possibility rationalization, of course. You have to done, right? Operational planning and control, where you have done that. 10 sessions or so on, you have done that. What are the books I have written down? One book, I don't know how to talk to you. Shigeo Shingo, The Study of Product, Product of Product, System Industry, Oil Industry, there are teams in this question book on SMB. Full book is there in SMB. There is a full book on proprietary. Then this is a wonderful book that I found. I bought some time back. I didn't read. Only recently I read and found that very interesting things are there. It keeps happening. I buy some book and keep reading and reading for those who feel some incident comes or some interesting thing comes and we do it. So what are the chapters are like in this particular book? It's a book on metal cutting theory and practice. The chapters are like the machining optimization and economics. There is a chapter. There is a chapter micro machining. And there is a chapter design for machining. Right? All three are seen. It's already there in the part of the syllabus. Then in that context, I found the professor's book as a very, very interesting book. And this book I came across, this book on this platform. There is an the platform called archive.org. So these are the oldest books are there. Oldest books are available. Oldest books are functional. Oldest books are available. 1700, 1500. Even though the book is printed, right? It means some library of America, the book is available. Right? It is a very, very excellent book that it is there. Then there is a book on operations and supply management. management in the chairs. In this, there is a chapter on operations technology, which basically describes the same thing. The latest in technology, which is going to discuss that particular thing. That's an important thing for the operations managers. This will come back. I just wanted to tell you, student. Suppose you take a lot of time, I should not miss this particular system.
Science by that creative manager.
created from management as well as industry. Now we must have done 5.6 course. So this entire topic that I am telling, I have chapter in this particular listing. And basically, I am not interested in the book. I am very just going to put the chapters, make some modifications. You are not supposed to put a book. You are not violating the copyright. So the entire procedure, the full details are available here. And in this particular book, they have given me what is the definition of industry. I have given my definition of industry. My definition of industry. Industry. Given by Narayana. This is given by the Society for Advancement of Management very early days. This is Society started by Frederick Teller. So they say industry engineering applies engineering knowledge and techniques. Now this is very, very important. I written this particular thing for this. That an industry engineer is using industry engineering knowledge. The knowledge used by an industry engineering knowledge of the foundation of industry. For the study, improvement, planning, and implementation of the method and system. Commercial method, commercial system. Then, for the same thing, qualitative and quantitative planning and various standards, including the procedures in the artistic work, commercial work, manufacturing work. In the organization of manufacturing work, what are the plans, what are the procedures, what are the targets to establish that you are using the engineering knowledge. Measuring actual results of the standards and taking suitable action, that is control. Operations planning and control. Planning is saying what you want to do. Control is what you are doing, make sure that it is happening. There are some problems, make some proper actions for that. Problems are coming. Whenever we plan things may not happen. Yesterday they are telling. They call some car, the car will come. They found good in the car goes there, and somewhere else. We said that we have to get some very important guest from the city. We said that we have to be in our job. After something suddenly remembered, we made the phone call. I never said, sir, I am in the vicinity, but I don't find the book in the office. So once again, you take a phone call, talk to your particular person, guest, sir, or man in auto book, and even to either into the driver and tell him all the questions. So control is, after making your plan, right, in the last minute, you have to keep on tracking, right? And if at all there are some problems in the last minute, you have to take some corrective actions. Just because you planned 5 years back, somebody will go and do this. May happen or may not. So the control is to track the particular event till it happens. After you plan, it should happen. When it happens, then it will happen. So this is all done to exercise better management. Special consideration for employee welfare, this is what the point. The human effort in engineering, we are talking, you are employing the people in this particular activity. The people should be happy, people should be hungry, people should be safe. This is your job to take care. So when you are an engineer, people are working on the group, you have to take care of yourself. You must ensure that they are going to be. You should decide what should be the proper salary for you. You should decide what is proper salary for you. Are you happy with the salary you are getting? You have to think. And you have to think of each and every fellow who is working with you. All of them should get the salary which they are. If they are not, they are unhappy, they will not be working. not only our department, other departments, they also should get a proper salary. If they don't get a proper salary, they are unhappy. If they are unhappy, they are not going to operate. So what are other people have to do, that doesn't matter. This is not happy, but sweepers are not happy. So they are not going to come as what will do for that? How do you ensure that what is the case to use to make sure that anybody is getting a required salary? In the stand of the technique, there is some technique which is supposed to use in management to make sure that anybody is getting a proper salary. Job evaluation. That's something that I think. The job evaluation. There you have to say, you pick some points. Say 500 points are there. The jobs with 500 points, their jobs with 100 points. Create a scale and they will create grades. You say what is the top grade? A grade job, what is a G grade job? You see A grade with this salary, G grade with this salary. So that something is new. Then there is something called merit rate, right? You say job evaluation and merit rate. What is merit rate? Merit rating is after a job is there, in two different people are put there, he is doing better, but the same is not doing better. There is a difference between A and B. So we want to say that if A is there, he is doing better. I give some new sign. If B is sitting there, he is not doing better, I give less money. First of all, the grade is there. In that grade, anybody sits in that grade, right? But in that grade, somebody is doing a better job, so he gets 50 because he is doing better. What is incentive scheme? You have some good incentive scheme somewhere. Like what is incentive scheme? Here it is numbers. Here it is numbers. If your department is there, that department is there, you have to be 40%, there will be 60%, they should get it. Month after month, they are being 40%, they are being 60%. You are saying 60% more. If you are getting 60% more than you, then you are something like, no, we are getting 40%. I do that for you, Mr. So you can get 40% more. Right? The incentive. Incentive is clearly visible, quantitative performance, yes, done that way. Merit rating is still qualitative, but still there is a visible. You are getting some 10 capital on the sofa, you are getting feedback, and you are ranking them one together. The top two faculty, we said these people are high merit, thus the students are showing more satisfaction. So these two faculty are doing some merit rating. Quality. Not quantity. Then faculty are all of them equal grade. Faculty is one. Certain people are considered to be better grade. They are able to create much more satisfaction. They are able to create much more loving by their. So all these things, why you are doing? That's what we want to take care of the human rights. Employee welfare aspect. So methods efficiency, when you talk of methods efficiency, then there are certain popular names which is called as a method study. The method study is there to improve the balance. Now, oral balance is the first PhD we must do. So you wrote a book on the emotional time study. They are the emotional time. Right? Now, ILO is a popular, you must also see. It is popular for us because Nitty when we started, ILO was a book. So the ILO is a burden for people so long with the ILO. The ILO was a book. Now, what happened is, in the archive.org, I came across this book by the Maynard and Stenberg operation analysis. Now, the method given by Maynard and Stenberg is different from the method given in the ILO method. Of course, balance contains this method. Briefly, balance contains this particular method. Now, I will discuss in this class the method of the operation analysis given by Maynard and Stenberg. You are free to ask questions anytime. All this lecture is clear from understanding. You should never go back. Stop. You can stop at any time. These are very self-control and peace of mind. Once you know the thing you feel, the pain that you feel, these are reasonably self-control and doing these slides. And we are going to also very really clear and free. So it doesn't matter if 2 hours we got enough. What can we look at it? Yes, yes, yes. You want any time break? You can make a new situation. Take that. Not an issue. So what is this particular, this thing, what is this method that we are talking of? It is a logical and systematic procedure for reducing costs, increasing production, reducing impairment of quality. Productivity does not mean reduction in quality. We are producing more, doesn't mean that quality is coming less. We are producing through the specification which is given to us for production. Whatever is the specification going to be in the price, I am going to produce as per the specification. I produce more, so productivity is more. I produce more, so cost is less. So it is the industrial science which is chiefly concerned with increasing the efficiency of resources used in the wasting of this cost wasting refers to the resources used to produce something. So when we try to reduce the resource consumption, we are reducing the cost. We use less power, we use less machine time, we use less cutting or lubricating oil, less cooling fluid, less number of cutting tools, everything less. As you are going to use less resources to produce something, the cost is less. Why should we reduce cost? What is the benefit of reduction of cost? Reduction of cost is each time the selling price of product is reduced, even though it is as little as 1%, the product is brought into the reach of more people. If you want to sell more, you have to reduce the price. If you want to grow, you have to reduce the price. You want growth? How much growth do you want? Do you hear? How much growth in India? How much growth do you want every year? Percentage? How much?
7%.
No problem. But if you want even 1% growth, you have to reduce the price of the product. Without reducing the price of the product, growth will come. Whatever items were sold this year, you want to sell more items next year, the first point is you should be able to reduce the price. Now you can reduce price only if you reduce the cost. Who is going to reduce the cost? Engineers. And first in the line are the industry engineers. Next in the line are the manufacturing engineers. Next in the line are the design engineers. If country doesn't grow, don't blame money. Country doesn't grow, blame a negative Surat. We are producing engineers who cannot reduce costs. The other thing is what? If income increases, growth will come. But how does income increase? Income increases only if cost comes down. So the subtle thing comes into that we engineers have to stretch our legs. Every day, every week, every month, we engineers have to come with new and new things. This is what we are learning in the institute. But you have to ask ourselves, so far what have I done with? What am I going to do new in my future? 30 years I am going to join, 40 years I am going to do a job. In 40 years, what new things I am going to do? And you have to develop yourself like not become a certain. Unfortunately, if you are acting particularly exam, you will be pass it. Not a matter. Institute are 6 month semester, all that you claim directness is exam for faculty. Is it the purpose? The purpose of 2 years education, whoever is funding, Sir, you are giving the money, your father-in-law is giving the money, government of India is giving the money. What is the purpose? Is the purpose for 6 months to do something else? One day to read some book, write something, and pass the exam? Will that education create in the future? Who is going to create in the future? Are you going to create? Are you going to create by reading by one day and writing some exam? And then come to teacher, sir, pass the exam. I don't get good jobs. Think of it. Think of what is the purpose. Doesn't mean that 24 hours you are going to study. Like I am going to study as a teacher, now you are going to study. I also get tired, when I get tired, I don't sleep. I think lecture boy, I don't sleep, but I don't sleep. 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 Each of us are going to get tired. So you should dedicate certain time. And you should say, this is the present time, what is it? Tomorrow I have to do the job, I have to dedicate, right? I have to come and lecture here, I have to dedicate some time and say that what I am going to do. I have to spend some time, come here. I cannot say that, I am not going to do it, I am not going to do it, I just want to lecture, okay? Doesn't work, right? Same thing for you, any opportunity. Therefore, cost reduction is a means of increasing the sales of the product. Why you should believe that new ways of reducing cost. Same thing, other thing is there. That I'm asking you. The assignment I'm asking you is try to tell me in last 5 years what happened to you. Right? The two important things. One thing is cost reduction. Other thing is increasing the utility. Right? Increasing the utility. Increase utility, people are going to give you more price. Right? An item which is sold for 1,000, it is today sold for 3,000. Why? Utility. Right? Camera. Earlier camera was 2,000. Camera. Mobile. Today mobile is 10,000. Why? You are saying there are two cameras. Front camera, back camera. There are two SIM cards. You can transfer data. You can transfer 4G, 3G, 2G. You have so much memory. Right? Actually it is a computer. It is more powerful than the computer and the desktop. On a simple phone which is used for only making a phone call, you are converting it into a tape recorder. You can even do it, Google Hangout. If you want, you can do a Google Hangout. You can just put it like this, or you can see me standing here. When I just putting this phone like this and putting it on, the entire world can see me live. Right? What you have done? The product utility, you are increasing the utility. Right? So one job of engineers is to keep on increasing the product more and more. The other job is, if public agrees to this product, if public is buying this product, then to reduce the cost of this product. As you reduce the cost of the product, more and more public is going to buy. Right? See, every product, to say it is successful, let us say 1 lakh people should buy the product. So once I create a product, if 1 lakh people buy the product is successful. If less than 1 lakh buy, not successful. But once 1 lakh people are buying the product, now 10 lakh should buy. Now 1 lakh to 10 lakh means I have to reduce the cost by 20%. Only when I can reduce the cost by 20%, this 1 lakh will become 10 lakhs. Another 20% reduce, this 10 lakhs will become 1 crore. Another 20% reduce, how many mobiles are being bought in the country now? 600 million? 700 million? This is the mobile number now. In India already, the mobile subscribers are 700 million. 70 crores. Right? I am talking stock in one day. First 1 lakh mobiles, 10 times 10 lakh mobiles, 1 crore mobiles, 10 crores mobiles, 100 crore mobiles, 11 crore mobiles. So this increase takes place as you are reducing cost. At every stage, cost is getting reduced. And this we are saying, can you do 1%, 0.5%, 0.1%? It doesn't happen in single stage. It happens every day. Every day, somebody creates an idea and says, in this one small component, my cost reduction occurred by 2%. But there are 30,000 components or 50,000. In 50,000 components, you have to have one. In that one component, you are reducing the cost of 10%. In fact, not only 0.001. But such 0.001s by 1000 engineers only add up to 10%. So you should not discount any engineer's contribution of that 0.1%.